Welcome to Chemo Experts to learn about blood clots. We will learn what are they, what do they look like, who gets them, and how do we treat them. Platelets bind at the site of blood vessel injury, forming a platelet plug. Fibers known as fibrin are then woven throughout the plug, forming a blood clot, which stabilizes it and prevents bleeding. Sometimes large blood clots develop in the veins of legs or arms and cause symptoms. These clots are known as a deep vein thrombosis, or DVT. Symptoms of a deep vein thrombosis include redness, swelling in an arm or leg, or pain. A blood clot in the leg is usually not life-threatening, but if it breaks free and travels up the bloodstream, it can be. When a blood clot breaks free and enters the bloodstream, they can ultimately get stuck in the brain, lungs, or heart. These clots are known as either a stroke, a pulmonary embolism or PE, a heart attack or myocardial infarction, and these three types of clots can all be life-threatening. A blood clot traveling to the lungs may cause shortness of breath, trouble breathing, chest pain, cough, or fast heart rate. A blood clot traveling to the heart may cause chest pain or tightness, jaw or arm pain, heartburn, shortness of breath, trouble breathing, cough, dizziness, or a fast heart rate as well. A blood clot traveling to the brain may cause confusion, trouble talking, inability to move parts of the body, weakness, headache, dizziness, or trouble walking. Knowing what symptoms to look for is key to preventing problems. A CT scan specifically looking at the blood vessels in the head or chest will help determine if a blood clot is present. Who gets blood clots? For several reasons, patients with cancer are at an increased risk for developing blood clots. For example, cancer cells can release substances that trigger the clotting cascade. Certain cancers do this more than others. Many other factors increase the risk of developing blood clots, such as recent surgery or long-term bed rest, long car or airplane rides, hormone replacement and various other medications, smoking, as well as obesity. How can you prevent blood clots? Be active. If you are in the hospital and unable to walk several times per day, your doctor may give you a medication to help lower your risk. If a DVT or PE occurs, medications can be taken to stop new clots from forming and prevent clots that already exist from getting bigger. These medications are known as anticoagulants and sometimes called blood thinners. There are many different types of anticoagulants. Warfarin and rivaroxaban are tablets taken orally, dalteparin and enoxaparin are sub-Q injections, and heparin or argatroban are usually reserved for IV infusions in the hospital. Very rarely, your physician may choose to place a special filter in your vein to block a clot in the leg from moving up to the lungs. Many treatment options exist for blood clots. Talk with your doctor to find out which is best for you. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and tell us what you think. Click pause now to read our disclaimer. And thank you for watching.